Hello guys, welcome to Algorithms Made Easy. My name is Rajat and today we will discuss why recursion fails, or more importantly, when recursion fails. To understand this particular concept, we will be taking a sample question in which we will be finding out the height of a binary tree. Now, here is a class which defines the structure of a binary tree. A tree has a left node, right node and a value attached to it. We have a constructor which defines the value. Now, here's a code which finds out the height of a binary tree, and as we all do, we'll try to find it first recursively. Here is a sample input that we are creating and passing in this method which finds out the height of a binary tree using recursion. The structure that we are creating over here is a skewed binary tree. In a balanced binary tree, it is very easy to find out the height of a tree and we won't be able to see why the recursion fails. So, for those of you who don't know what is a skew tree, let's discuss that quickly. The structure of a skew tree is like this, wherein all the nodes are aligned either the right child or the left child of a tree. So, this becomes quite unbalanced tree. In our case, we will be having hundreds and thousands of nodes on the skew tree so that it will be easy for us to see why the recursion is failing. So, let's try with a smaller value. There are 1500 nodes in a skewed binary tree and we try to find out the height of this tree. When we run this code, the program runs successfully and we get the height of our binary tree, which is 1500, and that's correct. Now, how about we increase the number of nodes and simulate a condition wherein we are getting a large number of input and the tree is skewed. When we run this code, we do not get any answer, we get an error, which is a stack overflow error. Now we'll discuss why we are getting this error, but firstly let's see, is there any way where we can find out the height of a binary tree that is skewed, which has around 15,000 of nodes attached to it. So if you thought about using an iterative approach, then you're right. Let's try to run this code using an iterative approach. So I have this code ready wherein we are finding out using the iterative approach. Now we are running for both iterative and recursive for the same input. And let's try to see if we get the answer for the iterative approach or not. So when we run this code, we are getting the answer from the iterative approach but getting the same error using the recursive approach. So what is the difference between the two approaches? The answer lies in the memory that it uses in order to solve this particular problem. In the recursion, the memory that we are using is called call stack, which is nothing but a simple stack, but it is used in order to hold the calling functions with the intermediate results so that it knows what to call next. While in the iterative approach, we are using a stack which is a simple data structures which is stored in the heap memory. So that becomes a first difference between the two approaches. Recursion uses a call stack and iterative uses a heap memory. Then also, why one fails and one succeeds? The answer lies in how the Java compiler allocate memories to the call stack or the heap memory. Java, according to its version, allocates anywhere between 320k to 1024k to the call stack. In Java 14, the default size is 1 MB. While for an iterative approach, the heap memory that we are using, Java allocates a default size of 256 MB. So that means we have a lot of heap memory as compared to the call stack. Now, there are tuning flags that we can use for both of these approaches so that we can increase them. But there is a limit to the value that you can assign to a call stack or the memory that you can assign, and it is close to 1 GB. While on the iterative approach, there is no such limit. You can increase it as per the memory available in your physical machine. We got to learn that for a large skew trees, if we follow a recursive approach, then there are chances that it will fail, while the iterative approach, on the other hand, is more likely to succeed in that environment. So now you know when to use an iterative approach and when to use a recursive approach. If you like this video, do like, share and subscribe to the channel. Do let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one.